Hello, my name is Matthew and I'm one of the team members. I work with Jacob and Martin and our team name is MMJ. What we made is a project, web application, managing projects and giving administrator and a comprehensive tool, for instance, to check students' reports and give them notes. This is how we came up with the idea of creating our application. Currently, we are students at Brussels University of Technology. During our studies, we attended few courses about different programming algorithms. The main form of the course, such as I mentioned, is the project. The project which name as, for example, data structures and computational complexity, consists of 5 partial projects, which have to be made by all of the students participating in the course. About 200 people in maximum 2 people groups. If we sum up that values, we will get the number of at least 500 projects. That's 100 groups and 5 partial projects. At present, projects are made in a paper form, and implementation code usually comes with the CD/DVD as an attachment. What is really funny, all of the project groups are held by one lecturer. So during the whole semester, one lecturer collects about 10,000 paper pages and 500 CDs, assuming that the project have an average of 220 pages. Let's imagine a lecturer holding 2 projects such as this one. The amount of the papers and the code files is really scary. What our system ensures is that the problem with the disposal of the paper waste will no longer exist, and the lecturer will be able to check the projects at any location on Earth. It is worth mentioning that the lecturer who leads the projects is a well-known professor and often travels to the various conferences or universities around the world. What's more, this tool has a feature that automatically detects plagiarism. It's very useful and can be very helpful in preventing copying reports. As an administrator, you will also have a knowledge about people who committed projects after deadline, which is really difficult to control if you have such a large number of projects. In the next step, you will see our web application in use. Okay, this is our project manager application, so let's see how we can use it. Now we will log in as an administrator to have access to all of the website features, type the user admin and the password as well. Let's go to the courses tab and choose one of the existing courses. Now you can see that course consists of a few projects, we'll choose sort algorithm. And this is the projects page, we help with read, report committed by users, give them notes and check for plagiarism. After we picked a note, there is a confirmation updated successfully. By clicking the user's report, we can read it, for example, in the new tab. Let's move to the projects and choose one of the list. For instance, simulated annealing. You can see few reports, but everyone is received after deadline, as it marked in the table. We will press check hyperlink to detect plagiarism. On the page plagiarism detection, we can notice that the reports of the user test and user 2 are very similar, like a copy. We'll open both of them and check it manually. As you can see on the screen, the projects are the same, so one student copied a work of the other. Let's back to the projects and give both students note 2 for cheating and student user 1 for example note 5. We will move to the actions manager. In this page, we have a list of all users. We can import users from XML Excel file, who picks XML file and As you can see, two users were added to our database, user 3 and admin 2. If we click on courses of the users 3, we can enroll student with the specified courses. We'll add second course and log off. Now we are logged in as a user 3, and after clicking projects tab, there is a list of 3 partial projects that have to be made by this student. We'll upload project number 1. As you can notice, it is received after deadline. Let's do the same with the rest 2 projects. We can easily manage our projects and, for example, delay them. All of the deadlines are near names of the partial projects. We will come back to the home page and log in as an admin user again, and go to the project and click the link to see all of them. We can see user 3 and his partial projects that we've already uploaded. We will pick the node 3 for the first one and log in as a user 3 to see changes. Now we are in the projects tab, and the project number 1 cannot be deleted due to the node that has been received, but you can still delete the rest 2 projects. To sum up, our web application has a lot of advantages, such as it's very simple and you can easily manage projects, reports and code files. Only administrator has a permission to use all of the features. Users' passwords are secured. If we type a wrong password, we will get an error message that something was incorrect, username or password or both of them. This tool is exactly what an administrator such as our professor needs. Moreover, it's very intuitive, so you can start managing your projects in just minutes. We want to develop that project in the future, mainly to connect system to the Azure platform to work in cloud. This will ensure good quality of service while it's in use by hundreds of users. Thank you for watching our promotional video about Web Application Project Manager. We hope you enjoyed it.